What are you doing?
I'm trying to find what's behind FoxDot.
Oh! Maybe there's another way?
Sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. Quite sure.
Okay.
Yeah. Welcome to Code Cooking
with CrashServer.
And a hammer.
And a hammer.
Yes. So, yeah, today we're going to see what's behind the curve of FoxDot. Mm. And maybe some SuperCollider. No, sure, sure.
Yeah, sure.
So, maybe let's go.
Switch to another world.
Transition. Yeah?
Yeah.
We have done the transition. Okay. So this is your classic FoxDot view. You all know and love.
Yeah.
So maybe we can just go like see what's in the file menus and all the menus.
Okay.
And go a little bit into explanation.
So file, or you can open, save.
Yeah.
Save is a good function.
Yeah. So you can save your code and recall your code. By the way, if you close FoxDot and reopen it without saving, it should write it into a temporary file. But if you really care about your code, I recommend you still save to be sure.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's the file menu. Then there is edit.
Edit.
So nothing really.
You can create.
Yes, there is something really important to here.
Oh.
The beat counter.
Oh yeah. Because it's not activated by default.
No, exactly.
So activated, and now as you see here, it just counts.
Yeah.
The beat.
Yeah. That's so you can make nice transition on time.
Yeah.
Or if you don't want to, just ignore it. You won't have sound, will you?
Oh, I think.
Are you sure?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
So you should. Three, four. Okay.
Exactly. Okay, in the edits, what else can we see? Transparency.
Transparency,
not. You can see. Language.
Language, yeah. Something almost important.
Yeah, quite important.
SC3 plugin.
Yeah.
What is
it? So basically, when you install FoxDot, there are some plugins you can install that allows you to do some effects, like more distortion, some instruments required, the piano.
Yeah, for example, piano. You know the piano, maybe you try to use it, but no
it
sound.
It makes an error, then no sound.
But
here it works.
I got sound because I use SC3 plugins.
Right.
But I need to install it.
How do you do that?
Oh. Go to the internet.
Oh, the internet.
You search for SC3 plugin SuperCollider and
you read the manual and you install it.
Just go here, SuperCollider SC3 plugin, there's a GitHub.
So depending on your system, it can be really easy, like you can maybe do it directly in Ubuntu, you can apt install it.
Yeah.
In other systems, maybe it's a little bit more difficult. In Windows, it's easy. If you want to compile it from source, it's also an option.
Mm-hmm.
It's depending. We will not go into all the details because that's much too much detail. Once you install it, this should work.
You can use piano. You can also, I think, this also Dist, works. Exact. So you have
some got distortion.
A big distortion.
Yeah. Nice. Okay. That's it for SC3 plugins. Then another really important thing, the help. Help is also always nice.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah.
Here, if you show in the console, you have some very useful function.
Yeah.
Like printf, where all.
Yeah, and then it lists all the syndefs you can use, or all the samples you can play.
All the samples,
the effects
list, attributes,
and methods.
The pattern methods.
Yeah. So that's good if you want to explore and try some new things. Maybe take a look at it. In the helps, there is some other stuff, I think.
Yeah,
very important.
Yeah. You can try to, if you have problem with your machine, you can try to lower the CPU usage or Maybe the latency you can...
So those are experimental features.
Yeah.
Exactly. We're not going to go into details either. CPU can be dependent on FoxDot, but also on SuperCollider. Mm. So it can be quite some... By default, it should work, but you can try if you want some specific usage.
Try to lower if you have problem, and latency maybe higher if you also have problem.
Yeah, like glitches. Yeah.
The sample folder.
That's important.
It's important.
Everything is important.
Yeah, everything. If you click on it, you will open your sample folder where all the sample are.
All the default samples are installed.
So,
so if you want to change your samples and customize it, here you can put some new samples in there.
As you see, I play X and...
this one.
Play X.
X.
Lower X, so it's on the X, lower.
And here you will...
And play the sample 0.
Yes.
This is a sample 1, sample 2, sample 3, sample 4.
Yeah, so you can add some new ones or replace the existing ones.
So if you want a new kick, you just add it here and there will be the sample 6 from the lower X.
Yes, and if you want to access it, you add into the FoxDot sample 6.
Yeah, of course, yeah, sample 6. But it doesn't exist yet.
No, so it will work. Okay, so I think that's about it for FoxDot.
Yeah, also, just... You also have the loop,
Want
more, have more
lengthy
sound, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe, go to...
Yeah, I have the things. Also, you can have a config file. Bon.
That's okay.
Yeah.
It's the same, but in a text way.
Yeah. And some tutorials.
Some tutorials from the website.
But be careful, because if you click on it, everything
will be removed. So be careful.
Okay, that's all for FoxDot. I think. Oh, the, a little shortcut. Quite.
Oh, show me a shortcut.
Yeah. Control D.
Oh yeah, duplicate.
Duplicate.
Yeah.
Wow.
Nice. I just learned about it.
Yep.
Okay.
Just a quick tips.
So now even deeper.
Yeah, deeper.
Let's go deeper. Can I do the dive?
No.
Okay. So now we are in SuperCollider. So what do we want to do here?
You should have a SuperCollider open.
Yeah, otherwise it won't work.
It doesn't work.
So
what's important? For FoxDot.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so
you,
the quarks?
Yeah, you can go to the quarks. In language.
Language, quarks.
Something called quarks. And now you see all the quarks you install.
So basically quarks are extensions, plugins. Okay. Let's
plugins,
say. So you can add more features to SuperCollider.
Yeah.
If you add some new synthesizers, sometimes they require some new quarks.
Yeah.
So yeah.
As you see, I have a SuperDot. If you have a tidal cycle,
for example,
you use a SuperDot and you have the FoxDot quarks.
Yeah, you've got feedback also here.
So maybe we can... Something really, maybe
really nice
can be interesting. It's if you open the file here,
you can change the way FoxDot starts.
Yeah.
How much memory it allocates.
Yeah.
How much, and that's really nice. If you want to use multiple channels, input channels or output channels, you can change the settings here.
As you can see here, I have a 16 output channel.
Yep.
Because in my SuperCollider here I have 16 outputs.
So you can play on a lot of speakers, for example.
Yeah.
You can reroute to pedals.
Yeah. So,
for example, or put some
FX
hardware
or
whatever. By the way, we have a tutorial on
multi-channel outputs. Yeah. If you want to record each player in a separate program.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that's here.
Or here.
No. I don't know how it works. It's first. Okay. So that's it.
That's
for the class.
Yeah. We also have something really cool. It's in the file, the open startup file.
Yeah.
So
when you boot, when you start SuperCollider, it will evaluate this file.
Mm-hmm.
So you can say automatically, I open FoxDot.
I put FoxDot here because I only use FoxDot.
Right. But you can put whatever you want in there. You can put like a
configuration. There's a stage limiter because we see
in the previous tutorial how that works.
Yeah, and the make window.
Yeah, but you can put some other things, some customizations, some whatever you want.
It's make windows, not make GUI.
Oh yeah, both works, right?
Both work.
Okay, nice. I think that's about it.
That's about
for the behind the FoxDots. Yeah.
Yeah, and there's other stuff, but
it's not an in-depth tutorial about SuperCollider because that would take 5 years.
5 years.
Something like that. So we will see further down the line a tutorial about how to make synthesis. So how to make new synthesizers for FoxDots. That's not in the scope of this tutorial. So that's all.
So. I don't need my hammer.
No, you just need a mouse and a click.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Great. See you.
See you. Bye.
Bye.